Someone once said a real rain would come and wash all the scum into the streets. I'm still waiting. What makes a good story, he'd often ask himself. It was dark that day, and it was hard to see. It was a blur outside, the streaks of rain as black as his coffee. His awful, stale coffee. It was a nice compliment to his awful, stale studio. It was here he drew his animations. And on a day like this one, the only thing he could do was draw. To pass the time. And often he sat and wondered, where does the time go, old man Jack? Where did it all go? Into the indentions on the palms of his hands? Or into a plastic sack? He'd been alone now for some time, confusing the sounds of the rain, the sounds of the air conditioner, or even the sounds of his own mind. It was dark that day, he thought, and it was hard to see. He walked around at night to get inspiration for his drawings. The raindrops were as thick as a plague of locusts, and the cracks in the sidewalk were snaking veins of mud. The rain helped to clear his mind, to see things that were really there and not imaginary, like a snail drowning in a puddle, all alone like him, with a dead wife and a daughter he could never find. It smelled of smoke and stale coffee and mold in this watery hell, he thought, but then he caught the scent of a flower, a rose. And then he spotted her across the street. An angel stood at the street corner. And time for him stood still, went backwards and repeated again. And he drew her. She became his inspiration. At last, the start of a new story, he thought. He approached her through the puddles and asked, with a slightly trembling voice, would you like my umbrella? Sure, she replied, and he came even closer. What's your name? He asked her, and she replied, Cherry Rose. Cherry Rose, he asked, would you like to get a cup of coffee with me? And she replied, sure. He was glad to have met this woman after being alone for so much time. Yet he kept finding himself staring into his mug, and in its blackness, he swore he could almost see his reflection. Did she just laugh at me, he thought, and he seized his mug. Cherry Rose, he said. It was an awkward conversation they had, exchanging a few words that didn't really mean anything. He got uncomfortable when she asked him what he did for a living. He liked to do things, but not for a living. She was so beautiful, and she smelled like a rose. And he gulped his coffee. It was awful, it was stale. He seized his mug and squeezed it as she eyed it with curiosity. His hands looked old, but he looked young. Am I odd to you? He asked. No, you aren't, she replied, but it was mostly out of kindness. Thanks, he said. And on that note, she turned away. He thought to himself, why do they always turn away? People like to turn and look even when there is nothing there. He watched her, and he watched the scum at the end of the way. Why was he following him again? His mug was empty. Neither half full nor half empty, just empty. He needed inspiration for his drawings. She smelled like a rose, a nice break from the mold. And he glanced at his hands once more. The lines were thick and dark. Thank you. was going crazy again, he tried to ignore the scum as he walked by. But he knew the man was watching him, smiling because he knew what was going to come. What makes a good story? I sure as hell don't know. And it makes me so sad that I don't know. It's so sad that a lifetime of work can end up being uninteresting to the rest of the world. She didn't want to go into the alley. He practically had to force her. The rain was a blur and the lightning went off like firecrackers. "Stop," he said to her, and she turned. "What is it? What do you want me to do?" she said. He only stared. "You know what makes a good story?" he asked. "Murder." They both looked at the clouds. She took her time. "It's dark today," he said. The rain was thick, but it would wash the blood from the street. It would leave everything clean. He scrubbed himself. Each movement of the hand brought him one step back to sanity. This was the cost of inspiration. The cost of inspiration. He had his story now. He just had to draw it all out. The rain helped clear his mind and see things that were really there and not just imaginary. But the scum, he still followed. "Who are you?" he asked.
"Who are you?"
he yelled. "She was no good," he said. Just a figment of his imagination. Just a figment of his imagination. He could deal with those. He had dealt with them before. He could deal with them. How do you know they're not there anyway? When you can't see because it's dark outside.
Ivy.